Now that we know how to utilize an if function, I'd like to talk to you about how to utilize something called a nested if function. And these nested if functions are going to become useful when we have more than one logical test. So let's just review the if function for a moment. So here on this previous tab, in the previous video, we actually discussed how to use this if function. So if I click on one of them, we're just going to examine this in the formula bar. It says equals if B2, so if the quantity is greater than or equal to 1,000. So if the quantity is more than 1,000, it's going to give them 10% because that's the first item, the value if true. And then if it's not greater than or equal to 1,000, it's going to give them 0%. And we can see that evaluated here. Quantity is less than 1,000, 0%. Quantity is more than 1,000, 10%. Quantity is at 1,000, 10%. Less than 1,000, 0, and so on and so forth. We want to take the same scenario. We want to add in maybe a couple more tests. For example, the policy is now at work that if they order 2,000 or more, I give them a 15% discount. If they order 1,000 or more, I give them the regular 10% discount. If both of those tests aren't true, I give them nothing. So in order to execute this type of evaluation, we would need to use something called a nested if. So here's how this is going to work. Again, I'm going to start with the equals, if, and then open bracket. And again, if we know how to type out these if functions, it becomes a lot easier for dealing with nested ifs. Now, when I quickly just went over what scenario we want to use, we had two tests. We have if the quantity is greater than 2,000, give them 15%, or if it's greater than 1,000, give them 10%. I need to do the largest test first, or the most important test first, okay? Now, how to determine that is based on different criteria, but if I'm checking if the quantity is greater than 2,000 compared to greater than 1,000, well, of course, I would need to do the 2,000 check first. So I'm going to say if B2 is greater than or equal to 2,000, comma. If that is true, I want to give them 15%, comma. If that is not true, I want to go do another if function. I want to go do my second test, okay? So in the false part of that first if function, I'm going to put another if function. So I'm going to do another if and then open bracket. And then I do my second test here. So I'm going to say if B2 is greater than or equal to 1,000, comma. If that's true, I'd like to give them 10%, comma. And if that's not true, I'm going to give them 0. Because if B2 is not greater than or equal to 1,000, well, it can't possibly be greater than or equal to 2,000. So essentially, this is the false for both statements here. So I'm going to put 0%, and here's the trick. I need to close the bracket for that first, or the nested if, this one, the second test, and I also need to close the bracket for the first if, or the main if. You notice it color codes your brackets here in Excel, which is really nice. I can keep track of them that way. So there I have a nested if. Let's make sure this works. So I'm going to go ahead and hit enter. Puts in 0 because the quantity is less than 2,000. It's also less than 1,000. If I fill that down, you'll notice it evaluates correctly. So there it is, more than 1,000, but less than 2,000. There's 10%. Same situation there, 10%. But here's one over 2,000. There's 15%. And again, just like I talked about in the other videos, if I change one of these, of course, the if function does update, and it puts in the proper value. Now, I'd like to go over one more type of evaluation here, so I'm just going to go ahead and delete this. We should talk about how to deal with text. So, new scenario. If they order 1,000 or more, yes, absolutely, I give them 10%. But if the company of OnTrack TV orders, I always give them 20%, they've been a long-standing customer. So if the company is OnTrack TV, they get 20%, or if the quantity ordered, disregarding what company it is over 1,000, they're going to get 10%. So here's how we would do that. Equals if, my first logical test is going to be based on the company name. So I'm going to say if A2 is equal to, and here's the trick, and again, this is kind of the main reason I wanted to go over this. If you're doing an evaluation on text, has to be in quotations. So if A2 and then in quote, or A2 equals and in quotations, OnTrack TV, close quotations. Well, if that's true, I'm going to give them 20% because they're the long-standing customer. They always get 20%. If that's not true, I need to go do my other test. So again, here goes another if function. So if, open bracket, in this case, the quantity is greater than or equal to 1,000, comma. If that's true, I'm going to give them 10%. If that's not true, I'm not going to give them anything. I close the bracket for the nested if. I close the bracket for the main if. And away we go. So again, why I've gone over this is just so you can see you can do comparisons to text. And you can do different logical tests in different columns or on different cells. So if I hit enter, there you go. That one's over 1,000, so it gets 10%. If I scroll down here, you'll notice that where the company was on Track TV, disregarding if this is over or under, it doesn't make a difference. That one's always going to get 20%. So there you go. Play around with those if functions as well as the nested if functions. They can be very useful when evaluating logical tests in your Excel spreadsheets.